Darren Legend Jr. here with my review of The Flash Season 4 premiere. The Flash used to be one of my favorite shows. I still contend that Season 1 is one of the all-time great origin stories for superheroes, and one of the best seasons of television that we've ever got. I was really doubting the show going in before I watched it, because I didn't really think The Flash could work on TV, but I was proven wrong immensely. Season 1 contained so many great characters, a great villain, a great hero. It was truly about someone embracing being a hero, and I really just love that. All the side characters are great. Every single episode, it's really strange for every single episode of a 22-episode season to work, and I thought Flash did that perfectly. Flash Season 1 did that perfectly. So yeah, I really love this show. Going in, and it used to be one of my all-time favorites. Then Season 2 came along, and that was a bit of a letdown with Zoom. And then Season 3, while it started off really fantastic, it went off the rails when they introduced yet another speedster villain, and it failed to really take some of the necessary risk to keep the stakes up. I thought maybe Iris should have died in that season finale. I keep switching things around and not really embracing the stakes of it at all. So with Season 4, I was a little skeptical going in because of, well, you know, what Season 2 and 3 were. But after watching the premiere, I think I might actually be back on the Flash train. I'm not perfect. The Flash Season 4 premiere does recapture some of the fun of the first season. It introduces a new interesting Big Bad and the Thinker, reintroduces friendships with Cisco and Caitlin, and houses some mind-blowing action that the Flash has always been famous for. Having not watched the Flash consecutively in a bit, it was nice to see Cisco and Caitlin rekindling their friendship. All of their one-on-one conversations felt earned and emotional. It was like watching a brother and sister, you know, after being apart for so long. It was also great to see Joe West back. Jesse L. Martin is so damn charming in this role and ups every single scene he's in. He's completely committed to this role, and I really like watching him act on screen. And I'm glad they gave him a relationship. It's nice seeing him kind of fall in love. It's nice. The writers also seem to have finally found their stride with Wally. I mean, I know this is just first episode of the season, but Wally, every single time I've tuned in, like, Wally annoyed the hell out of me in Season 2. In Season 3, every single time I tuned in, he was still annoying. He's just a very annoying character, and I don't think the writers, the thing is that it kind of annoys me too, is I think he's an easy character to fix with the writing of his character. And they always just make him feel like he comes off really whiny. And even, like, whenever the writers, like, I remember in the crossover last year, the writers gave him his moment of, like, helping out with the superheroes, but then they, like, kicked his ass later, and it's just like, why would you do that? you're just pulling the rug under your character for no reason. It's weird, but they seem to finally maybe have found this writer, Wally. He seems to have a real place on the team. And, you know, he's delivering his run-liners with ease. He just seems like more of a character. And more like he has actual reason to be there. And everybody's not like, oh, God, Wally's here. Oh, God. Like, everybody's just like, you know, he feels like he's a piece of the puzzle in all this. So really enjoyed the villain of the week. At first, I was like, he has swords? Okay. But he showed up to play and gave us some really entertaining set pieces. The set pieces on The Flash have always been a highlight for me. I love sitting back and wonder, like, man, this is on TV. This is a fucking TV show. I can't wait to see what else they come up with this season, because I really like that chase through the fans and everything, and he's carrying Iris. I thought that was fantastic. I really enjoyed that. Now, as I said before, this premiere wasn't perfect. For one, I really wish they kept Barry in the Speed Force for a little longer. I really wanted to feel the absence of Barry after what happened in the Season 3 finale when he went into the Speed Force. And I think keeping him gone for at least 4 or 5 episodes would have been interesting and ballsy to see. I think it would have given some of the side characters more time to mourn and more time to, you know, come into themselves and be the heroes they need to be without the Flash. I thought that would have been interesting, and, you know, just giving some the side characters more time and just seeing more of their desperation, I think, would have been a lot of fun. And also, it would have forgiven what they did with Flashpoint in Season 3, because a lot of people said Flashpoint should have gone on a little longer. Maybe it should have, just to do something a little bit more ballsy. Yeah, I just wish that Barry was stuck in the feet Speed Force a little bit more. Two, I don't think this show has a single clue what to do with Iris West. I mean, she's the leader of Team Flash now? I mean, what? I mean, what happened to being a reporter? Like, what happened? Like, I mean, how is she getting paid? How are any of these people getting paid? I want to know, but yeah, it just seems like a really weird, unearned direction for her character to go down. Also, I really feel like I'm going to hate the subplot with Caitlin. Struggling with Killer Frost, the Killer Frost personality, sure, whatever. But this whole bar fiasco that they're going through, and like there's that weird guy with the eye, what the fuck? What is that? I mean, what is that? I really hope it's not something we see again. I doubt it. I doubt that, you know, I think they're going to go in that direction. But yeah, I just really hope this whole thing is left alone in this premiere. I don't want to see that again. We're probably going to, unfortunately, but I just think that's a really dumb subplot that I hope we do not follow. Overall, I'm back on the Flash train. I'm looking forward to a couple of the new developments, and the idea of finally having a non-speedster villain is something that I really want to see play out. Hopefully in the season we can recapture the lightning in the bottle that was season one, and we can get a really good Flash show going on forward. So what'd you guys think of the season 4 premiere of Flash? Please let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up, and if you like hearing me talk about movies, please hit that subscribe button, come join the conversation, I'll be glad to have you. Also, check out my other channel, Till the Last Credit, another channel I co-run over there. We're doing Halloween commentaries, and if you guys want to see any of my coverage from New York Comic Con, I did some videos over there for that, so go head over and check that out. If you want to find me on social media, at Darren Lizzie Jr. on Twitter, and yeah. So with all that being said, I'll catch you guys next time.